I'm here on Headingley Lane, opposite the entrance to Bainbrigge Road, down the side of St. Michael's Church, where a very brave steeplejack has been doing some work this week. We can see here at 5:45 on a Saturday evening, it's quite busy. There's been a match on at Headingley of some description. Now what you saw there was a car coming out right turn from Bainbrigge Road, and what a councillor privately told me just yesterday was that he thought that massive saving times on the flow through of traffic here in Headingley could be achieved by simple measures such as making this a no right turn junction, both for traffic going in like that car you just saw there, or traffic coming out like the car we saw a minute ago. So we've already seen two cars, and you can see here there's a yellow square box where people have to stop. Not being a car driver, I hadn't really noticed this before, but now that it's been drawn to my attention, I think it's very interesting how a junction like this can make massive difference to the flow of traffic on this road. Now, there we have it, another car pulling out. Now that's doing a left-hand turn, you see, so it's not making a lot of difference. And we have another car coming here. So you can see that this being probably one of the main pinch points. Oh, here we are. Look, there's another car trying to get in there. Car trying to get in there. So that car there had to slow down as a result of it. Time of high spirits around here, with a lot of people having a bit of drink. But so I've already seen three or four cars coming in and out of this road here, and that car there, the taxi, is obviously standing back so that there is a constant stop-start. There we are, look, there we are. That bus there had to make way. There's another car gone past there. The bus, the traffic coming down that side is continually held up by cars either pulling out from that side or cars turning right from the main road into it. Now, there is a traffic light up there. But as we see here, now the traffic is moving on. The car coming out there, interrupting the flow of the traffic here, where that car would have been faster through. And this is only a moderate Saturday afternoon. But here we see the traffic's all backing up. But actually, in some places it can move more smoothly. So I've actually seen on the television demonstrations of how interruptions like those caused at this junction can cause, there we go, another car's having to stop there because it's got a clear run. So that's just slowed down. It's caused a knock-on bump effect with the bus is having to wait in the yellow box. Just making it go past these people. There we go. And until one of the local councillors drew it to my attention on when I was speaking to him yesterday, urging him to vote against the Transport and Works Order, which would allow the building of roads through the areas that I've previously documented. We see here constant stop starting of traffic because of this yellow box. Now here we have a car coming out. Car there is having to stop. Car there. Even that left-hand turning ace car there is making an interruption in traffic. And again we've got, oh yeah, this is going to be a good one, this is going to slow the traffic up. There's this van here. Now this car here is going to have to stop to give way. And so on and so forth. So they're constantly starting and stopping the traffic here. Okay. Right, well I think I've made my point now.